Hi, it's Mick from Crypto Coaching here, and what we're going to have a quick look at is setting up the CoinSpot 2-factor authentication, which is a must-do to help further protect your account. We'll click on Enable 2FA, which brings you to the security page, 2-factor authentication, and what we'll do is click on Enable 2-factor authentication. On the phone, we'll click on the Google Authenticator app, put in a new account, scan barcode, and now we're ready to scan the QR code up on the screen of the computer. Okay, we'll scan the QR code up on the screen here. Get it lined up. There we go. 867265, and we'll type that in. In the token bar here. Oh no, it's changed already. You've got to be quick on these. 163084. You only have about 15 seconds or so with these codes. Setup is now complete. Two-factor authentication is now active on your account. What we'll do, we'll log out and then we'll log back in, put our password in, and then we'll have to put our new two-factor authentication in. Click on Not a Robot. Log in on our phone, we'll open up the application, and on this one we got 653835. Click on submit and we're into our page. There's just another layer of security and just stop these hackers getting into your account. Okay, before you scan the QR code, just take a mini screenshot or something similar of the 32 character code here and the QR code, because once you scan this code, it will disappear and then you'll have to start the process again, because you really do have to keep this code or these two codes somewhere safe, because if your phone or your scanning device goes missing or plays up, you will not be able to get access back into your account. And if, like I said, if the scanning device plays up, you might have to manually put in that 32 character code. And the more levels of security you have, the less chance hackers get in. And to do a mini screenshot, I'm on Windows 7. Go down to the start menu, type in snipping tool. We have here, do a rectangular snip. There's your code. Put it somewhere safe. At the moment, we're just doing the desktop for this exercise. I've already got one there, so we'll have to just replace that. And there you have your code. And then make sure you store that somewhere safe, because one day you will need it. Okay, if you found this video of value to you, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe. And thank you very much for your time in watching.